Oh, my boy. You want your hair done too? Okay.
Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. This video has been a long-awaited video, and I waited to do this until my hair was actually at a point where I actually enjoyed it again. My hair has been through a lot. It's been blonde, it's been blue, it's been purple, it's been many different shades, it's been short, it's been long, but now it's finally back to like the OG Bailey stage, and I'm ready to share with you some of my hair care favorites and what I do kind of like on the daily with my hair to make it grow and look fabulous and gorgeous. So if you haven't subscribed, please make sure you subscribe by hitting the subscribe button down below and the notification bell, so when my crazy ass posts a new video, if I ever do, you'll be notified. Okay, so the majority of this video is going to be me showing you and kind of doing a little like how to get my like glam hair with my Roger Medina hair extensions. Roger Medina is a Canadian hairstylist. He's actually from Winnipeg, and our like friend groups like really like overlapped a lot. Like, he's just amazing. And so he has his own hair extensions. Actually, fun fact, he used to live in the same building that I'm living in right now. So like, it's so weird. We're like so intertwined. Anyway, he launched hair extensions, and you guys, they're so nice. This is not a sponsored video, but like, they're genuinely so gorgeous. I just need to share with you guys. I recommend these to every single bride if I do their hair. They're gorgeous. So Roger launched 18 different shades of hair extensions, which is a pretty vast shade range. I am wearing the shade Black Pepper, which is like a nice cool tone black. These extensions are 22 inches long. You get 220 grams and there are 8 pieces that come with this. And specifically, I love the different sizes of the extensions because I freaking hate when there's like two and like two. I like when they're like big, long, huge like wefts of hair that I can just shove into my head. So before I get into like how I style all this gorgeousness, let's talk about kind of what I do like with my hair care. It's taken me like 2 years to actually grow my hair out to a decent length now, and since I do have the extensions in, my hair is just so much fuller and there's more volume to it. As you know, my hair is like this like thin little like floppy, you know, my eyelashes and my hair, they're very, very similar. So that's why I love wearing extensions, because it actually like gives me more volume to my hair instead of this like tiny little like wee little thing. This is literally my ponytail right here. I wash my hair about, I want to say like 2 to 3 times a week. I have a lot of baths and I don't put a lot of heat on my hair. I never blow dry my hair. If I am straightening my hair, I do it ever so lightly. My hair is naturally, it was straight, but now it's kind of growing in like wavy. It's very strange to me. But the shampoo and conditioner I have been using is this by OGX. I love this stuff. This is the Nicole Guerrero collab, and this is Midnight Kisses. I just like it because it's in black packaging, to be honest. It smells really great. It has warm vanilla and orange in it, which is like some of the same notes as my favorite fragrance, which is Armani Code. So you can see my like vibe that I have here. I love this stuff. And typically in the shower, or typically I have baths, so I'll let the conditioner like soak on my hair for like 10 minutes. Love it. When I get out of the shower, I always put a product in my hair. I also just find that that helps it air dry. Again, I don't even remember the last time I've blow dried my hair. Like, I'm not joking. Like, I think it's been like 3 or 4 years. It's been a while. And I know my hair isn't curly, but I love using this product. So this is the Marc Anthony Strictly Curls. It's a leave-in treatment, foam treatment for curly hair. And it has like 7 in 1. So it defrizzes, defines, moisturizes, detangles, smooths, softens, and shines. It's a mousse. I use like maybe a little bit more than that, and it just makes my hair so freaking smooth and so soft. Dude, I know it's not for curly hair, but it does the same thing, I think, for curly hair, for my straight ass like hair. And it's just, my hair like, it's just so soft with this. I highly recommend this. Or I mean, any like leave-in treatment. I just find that like, if I put it, I cannot put a leave-in conditioner in my hair because it just feels too heavy and then my hair gets so greasy. But I find with this, it's nice and light. This is freaking me out. It's nice and light and airy, and it doesn't weigh down my hair. I'm a huge fan of dry shampoo. You will always find me putting dry shampoo in my hair. Ever since I had color hair, where I couldn't wash my hair all the time, or else it was like literally like with blue hair, it was like washing my skin with Windex. I don't miss showering with blue hair. I would wash my hair in the sink a lot though. These are my two favorite dry shampoos. So this is the OGX Bamboo Fiber Full Dry Shampoo. It's in an aerosol can. I really like this one because it doesn't leave any like white in my hair. It's pretty much colorless after you kind of like rub it in. Even when you do spray it, I can like spray it right here and it's not really gonna show up as like a white patch in my hair. It has with bamboo fibers and soy protein to help revive volume and body and absorb oil and to freshen and beautify, which yeah, I need all the volume I can get really. Like this is my hair like teasing the crap out of it. It's just very flat. I'm okay with it though. My other favorite is this guy. And I remember this being super expensive. I think it was $30.95 or something, which is like crazy for a dry shampoo. I do like this one. I travel with this a lot because it's just a powder in here with a little spout that you just foof foof and it comes out. This guy I bought because it was in a salon by where I was when I was traveling to Ottawa once. This guy though, it will leave a little white cast in your hair. I did use this today actually, so after you rub it in, it's not too bad, but just be aware of that. This isn't like an, I keep dipping my hand in this stupid phone. This isn't like an easy like put it in and like walk out the door. You actually have to be aware that it might be a little powdery up here. Those are all kind of like my favorite like go-to hair products for this moment. Now I'm gonna show you how to style my hair in my favorite style. Before I style my hair, I will always put in a dry shampoo. I find that when I'm putting in extensions, it just grabs onto my hair easier instead of it sliding away from my hair. And again, I will either use either one of these. The spray one is really simple. It like disappears in your head. It's like translucent. And then the caviar, I don't even think I said it was caviar. This is, yeah, caviar anti-aging. This one, again, the white cast, you really have to make sure you really rub it into your head, into your scalp. Now, let's talk about the installation of my Roger Medina hair extensions. You guys, I love the quality of these. They're just so beautiful. Like, the way that this, like, weft is, like, sewn, it's just, I can tell that it's, like, such quality, and I feel like because he's so, like, particular and like gorgeous and like stunning, like this is really like a product of him. So in the 220 gram pack you get many different sizes of wefts. So you get 2 1-inch wefts. I rarely ever use 1-inch wefts, particularly on me. I just like going for the full monty here and putting like just huge bands of hair in my hair. I just find that that's a lot easier and it's a lot less finicky for me. So it comes with 2 1-inch, 2 4-inch wefts, which I really like these for putting directly like in my front hairline here. I just find that that really like adds a lot of like nice volume in the front without the weft being too large. It also comes with 2 6-inch wefts. I really like putting these really at the nape of my neck and then right at the crown of my head. Then you get 1 7.5-inch, which is a huge weft. And then 1 8-inch weft as well, which is a little bit bigger. I really love the 7.5-inch and the 8-inch weft because even on a lazy day, I can throw those 2 wefts in my hair on different levels and I feel like my hair already has enough volume without me like being like, oh God, I gotta put my extensions in. So let's put these puppies in. What I always do is I'll figure out how many I wanna put in my head and that'll determine kind of me like where I'm gonna map out on my head the extensions. So today I'm not gonna use all of the extensions in my head because it's quite a lot of hair just because my hair is so thin. I don't feel like for me I need all of that. I always divide my hair right above my ears and that's where I'm going to put my first weft. For me, because my hair is so fine, I always back comb my hair just to make sure that the actual clip does stick into my hair when it clips on. Not that these clips are loose or don't stick, like you can hear, they're very snappy. But just to make sure, even if I'm brushing or I get my hair pulled or something, my hair is gonna be secured because I do have a little bit of back combing there. So at the bottom, I put the 7.5 weft. Again, I divided my hair the same way. I kind of went a little bit higher, did a little teasing. You can totally add a little hairspray at this point as well if you find that you want a little bit more tack on where your clip is gonna go. Then I put the 8-inch weft in my hair, and this one is nice and big and has a lot of hair and a lot of weight to it. At the very crown of my head, I decided to put a 6-inch weft there, which only has 3 clips on it. So I just teased where I knew that the clips are gonna go. Sometimes I don't tease an entire band around my hair. I'll just tease where I know that the clips are going to land. Then once I had built up all of my layers on the back of my head, what I like to do is I like to put the 4-inch wefts right at the top of my hair here, just to kind of crown the top to match with the other weft in the back and to add a little bit of volume on the side. Once the hair is all installed, at this point, literally all I do is curl my hair. So today I'm curling my hair with this guy. I've had this forever. This is a QT Performance hair styler. What is this, like an inch and a quarter? No, I think it's just an inch. I love this styler. It's my favorite curling wand. There's nothing more I can say about it. I've had this for years. Like, I want to say like 3 or 4 years I've had this guy for. Like, that's a long time. So for today's hairstyle, to get this like cute little like retro feeling look, I'm going to be curling my hair all in one direction. So I'm going to be curling it like towards my face on the right side. So I want this like nice like loop-de-loop. So that's what I'm going to do. So on my left side, I'm going to curl away from my face, creating this like whole like wave all the way around to my other side. I am going to be using these little duck clips, and these are just from Salon Care. You can get this at like Sally's. I love using these little clips to hold my curls in place once I've curled, especially if I'm doing like this look where I need the curl to be like super like up and held and defined. That's where I'm going to use clips to hold my hair until it cools down, so then I can brush it all out. But my hair's all curled and all done up in this cute little clippy bob bit. What I do, I let it cool down because then the curl is going to secure in place, and then I let my hair down and then I just brush out the curls. I use this brush. I actually got this in school. This is the Anti-Static Ionic 27. It's so dirty and so gross, but I love this brush. But I'm not really gonna show it on camera because it's so embarrassing, because it's so dirty. So this is what it's called, okay? So I just brush out my curl and I kind of manipulate the curls to go in their direction. I play around, I do a little back combing. After time, you just get used to doing this whole thing. The one section that I will really back comb on the top of my head is right on the front of my hair, on the side of my hair that is kind of flipping in towards my face, just to give a little bit of extra lift and volume there. I feel like that shape is really nice. And then I'll go in with a little bit of hairspray after the curls are kind of in the place that I want. This is my ride or die hairspray. This is the Got to Be Glued. This is, I don't love any other hairspray really. Well, sometimes I do, but this is my go-to. I will always, anytime I'm in a drugstore or Walmart, or anytime I need to buy hairspray, this is the hairspray I will purchase. It's the best. It holds your hair in place. I just freaking love this. It's just amazing. Then once my hair is all sprayed, I will put in one final product. I put this in my hair anytime I'm really styling my hair. So this is the Moroccan oil treatment, and I haven't put any in yet. So I'm just gonna take a little pump there, rub it in, and this just smooths the heck out of my hair, especially in these winter months. It's so staticky. So I'll just run this over, and it smells so good. It's like I'm at the spa. And y'all, that is my hair routine. That was a lot. That was a lot to take in. This has taken me a while. It took me a long time to do this. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to check out his hair extensions, I'll leave a link, or else you can just go to RogerMedinaHairExtensions.com and you can check them out. I do love them. They're such great quality, and I love supporting hairstylists, Canadian hairstylists and Canadians. So congrats to him on launching his hair extensions. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Ooh la la, I feel so beautiful. I'm literally, I have no plans for today. Maybe I should like go to the mall. Just, I don't go to malls. I don't know why I said that. Anyway, bye guys.